Argentina, Fernando Borrero. As we get a chance to look at the match format, it is best of five sets with the scoring system being rally scoring, not side out here, so all rallies will result in a point. The first four sets will go to 25. You must win by two. Now, if a fifth set becomes necessary, that one will only be to 15, of course, winning by two in that as well. Two official timeouts per set, and each team will get one strategic timeout per set as well. Well, we knew that Team Argentina would have the home court advantage throughout the tournament. What we didn't know is what they would do with it. Well, Dorothy, they've received great efforts from a variety of players. In particular, one player who stepped forward is Jorge Elgueta.
Elgueta, he's just been very consistent throughout this tournament. He's very versatile. They can play him in any position, as they were forced to do when Cuminetti was out with an injury. And he just comes through at all calls. You know, he's there when you need him. And he's a consistent player. He's very poised on the court. Just a fun guy to watch and really pulls him through in a clutch.
Well, one of several different weapons that they have as a result of efforts such as those of Elgueta. Argentina, a perfect 3-0 in this tournament, including a stunning three-set sweep of Team Cuba, and getting contributions, that is, from a variety of areas. And we're going to get a chance to look at the starting lineup. It starts with the big fella, the Terminator, Milinkovic, at 2'2". That's 6'8". And Elgueta, who we just saw, has the 38 kills. Middle blocker for them, Spacic, 14 kills for him. But the guy it revolves around is this next guy, Javier Weber.
Javier Weber, the setter for Argentina. You know, he only stands at 5'11", but you wouldn't know it. He plays like he's 6'8", and he just does a fantastic job.
Well, Carlos Cuminetti, 42 kills in only two matches for him. And Pablo Pereira did not start in the first match, but he has become a very important part of this Argentine team. Well, for Team USA, this has been a forgettable trip to Argentina. They're sitting here at 0-3, and one player that they'll look to is consistent outside hitter Mike Lambert.
Mike Lambert, yeah, with Doug Beal, with Coach Beal shuffling the lineups, he has been pretty consistent with Lambert. Lambert's been the catalyst for them as far as the attackers go. He's playing the opposite position, and they're going to have to rely on him tonight a lot just to at least get a chemistry going out there.
Well, he doesn't have any one particular game with a lot of kills, but he does have 9-10 in each of the times that he was out there, and he will need to come up big along with the rest of his teammates who've got a lot of pride on the line here tonight. Take a look at the starting lineups. Loy Ball, he's the setter.
Yeah, Loy Ball. He comes in at 6'8". That's a lot of setter out there, and he does a real good job running the offense.
And he'd be looking for that guy who we told you about, Mike Lambert. Also starting will be Tom Sorensen out of Pepperdine. Tom Hoff out of Long Beach State. Double-figure points in each of the last two matches. And Jeff Nygaard, who hasn't played much here, only four of the 11 sets has he been active in. And the final starter will be Kevin Barnett, also out of Pepperdine. He does have a 17-kill performance earlier in this tournament against Venezuela. Well, will Team Argentina remain unbeaten, or will Team USA crack into the win column? We're going to find out when we come back. The start of the match is next. America's Cup Volleyball continues right here on ESPN.